jump in this situation. It's a very tiny ramp for him to wall off at the front, and it's quite protected back here, and Vicuna won't actually have those mutas anytime soon.
That is for sure.
So the factory is put down near the front of the base.
Lining up to possibly, do the reactor switch, reactor on the barracks that just started.
So this will probably be for a bunch of Hellions that Forrest brings in with the Reaper to do some harassment, maybe kill a couple drones, hopefully get a queen. He's going to get that drone. He's going to kill a Ling first and then target down that weakened drone.
Gets it. There we go.
So he does get a few kills here. That Reaper's really low.
And it will escape. Now, where are the queens? Are there no queens out?
No, there are. Queens out. I think they just came out.
Now, we might actually see a starport. I think we will. Yeah,
so just put it down.
Banshee follow-up, probably.
So with this, you could do, as you said, the old switcheroo with a tech lab, get the Banshee and the cloak, and then come in through the front of the Zerg base with a couple Hellions and that Reaper.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a lot of Lings looking to do some damage to the wall. But not going to get anything done.
Yeah, and the Hellions get out just in time to deny the wall poke. And
another quick lair for Big Kahuna.
Yep, quick lair. Roach Warren playing fairly defensive. Needs to lift up that. There we go. Lifts up the starport. Going to start the Banshee any moment now.
I think these are actually just going to be defensive roaches.
Yeah, doesn't want to deal with the potential Hellbat timing, so you get a few roaches, or at least you have the Roach Warren in case you need it.
He's starting to spy some spine crawlers as well. He knows that he needs to buy a little bit more time for the roaches to come out. The Hellions actually are okay. They're now going to the main, or no, change their mind. Again? Nope, now they're going to the main.
Those Hellions could have roasted a few of the Lings, but they're just going to meet up with the Hellions that are currently at the third base. So they'll be able to pick off at that hatchery. Roaches are out to help deflect this, and roaches are just so good at killing Hellions.
Yeah, but they're so slow, the Hellions can just retreat back. Now the Banshee is on the way. The second one also being in production. I think it was maybe just barely missed by that Overseer. So while these Hellions and Reapers and Reaper is very distracting at the front of the base, this Banshee is going to get as much work as it possibly can get done in the natural. There are no Spore Crawlers up currently. How many drones is it going to get? Oh, gets that one trying to turn into a spore crawler. Banshees do two-hit drones. This queen could possibly be taken down as well.
It looks like it will be. And I think that's a pretty great choice because the Overseer is in production. The queen's the only thing that could really shoot up anyway, though. And there's also nothing really stopping this in the main. Overseer is now out, so this queen will be able to go to work, but if he just focuses down some more drones, he's going to get a lot of work done. How many kills does this get? 10 kills already. Okay. Oh, goes down.
Loses it. Well, I suppose that's okay. Since he got so much work done, one of those kills was a queen. I'm not sure where the second Banshee went.
Second Banshee. Let's see.
Maybe he canceled it. No?
No. It's.
I guess just going to meet up with the Hellions. Nidus for Big Kahuna again. Maybe feeling the pressure.
Possibly. And yeah, I guess just, well, with this Roach Force, you don't really want to move out on the map with it in case the Banshees do find your Roaches mid-map. You'll lose a few just trying to walk over there. So if you Nidus in, then that saves the transport time. Makes it so you don't really need Roach speed either. Has that been researched? Okay, it has been researched.
Well, there is an Overseer. I think that's an Overseer. Never mind, it died. Okay, so there's an Overlord behind the backyard expansion of Forest Gump and an Overlord near the front yard expansion as well. He could build a Nidus at either of these locations, or both.
Yeah, both is a definite possibility.
And this hatchery is actually going to go down.
Yeah, I don't think he cares about it anymore, though. I think he's going all in on this Nidus pressure.
Well, I think he definitely has to forfeit that base, because he doesn't have anything to take care of it right now.
Yeah. He actually morphed an Overseer next to that, even though he already had an Overseer there. There's just, like, the only issue is that there's nothing that shoots up. Like, that's the only problem there. And the Banshee will get away.
Well, that Nidus did complete, but the Roaches just ended up walking across the map anyway, so I suppose the Hydras that are going to be morphed in shortly.
But this is a really nice defensive position. Four Widowmines, a bunch of Marauders.
Sending one Roach at a time.
Oh,
no.
God.
Oh, he's going to get some really good hits on those Roaches. That supply depot needs to be repaired.
Nothing's being
pulled. It's on fire.
It might fall down. It takes a while for that to burn down, but I think it's going to go. The SCV's come. Are they going to get it? They will.
Just in time. It's on fire. Like your name if you're super cool and support ASL.
It turns out... before they moved over there to repair. And these lanes should probably leave.
These lanes are going to do what they want.
Yeah, okay. Okay, they'll do what they want. Start chipping away at this base. Not going to be able to kill it, that's for sure. And I'd really like to see the Nidus pop up maybe, you know, between the main and the natural.
Or there's some dead space where there's visionless for Forest Gump. Ah, that Overlord catches that Banshee. Trying to sneak in.
So the fence should be ready for the Banshee. Is there going to be a response to it? I believe there are spores in the natural. Banshee is getting hit.
I don't think he ever made any Hydras.
Nope.
Okay. Okay, so this Banshee's gonna die now. Actually, that's four. Hydra's finally in production.
Okay, so yeah, very big Roach Hydra mid-game. Drop loads up in the main of Forest Gump. It's gonna move across the map, try and do some damage. And Big Kahuna's chasing down that bio with his Roaches.
This is only a small portion of Forest Gump's army. Like, Big Kahuna is in some serious trouble, so it's three base versus three base. And Forrest Gump has, like, a ton more workers and mules. Like, he's just gonna max out, walk over there, and kill him. Actually, you could just do that right now.
Yeah, double the army spot. We got Swarm Host.
Okay.
And Flying Locust.
So he's maybe going to use these to fly in at the backyard expansion. I know that's popular among Hydra, actually.
Yeah. I mean, I've seen it a few other times, but we most recently saw it from Hydra at the WCS finals. So it could be emulating that style, but there aren't really, like... Yeah, just two Swarmless. And I guess, I mean, the Locusts do a lot of DPS, but two seems like...
That's not quite enough. You need, like, four or five.
Yeah, I think the magic number is...
I think it's actually five.
Yeah, five to snipe a town hall in one volley. And if it takes you more than one volley, well, one, the Terran can repair it. And two, that's like they're a minute apart.
Yeah, that's true. It does take an awfully long time with that change because of Fire Cake. Anyway, it looks like Forrest is getting ready to go and kill Big Kahuna. Oh, that one of mine does get sniped. All these roaches. Some get caught behind the Hydras, but there are definitely not enough roaches here to buffer for the Hydras. Even though the Hydras do, they do a ton of DPS, but there's so much bio here. Big Kahuna in a big heap of trouble. He's getting dumped on by Forrest Gump and the Dump Truck Green. Burrow is not going to be enough in this case. That 100 is a little suicidal. So are these three. Oh my god. Those Hydras. Oh.
The Locusts try and get something done. Yeah, shot down by Widow Mines.
Okay, that's the wrong direction.
Okay. That's fine. That's fine.
Well, it did kill one thing.
Yeah.
But this third is going to go down. Forrest Gump is going to be on four bases soon.
I'm not sure if you realize that you don't have to burrow the swarm host anymore.
Yeah,
they
you can
do their own thing.
You can just, like, trigger them. So now Big Kahuna stuck in his main. These Locusts are going to try and get something done, but there's so many medevacs with this bio, and this is really it. I mean, Big Kahuna was in a heap of trouble earlier, but now he's really going to feel the pressure.
I think this bio
is kind of like blocking itself, actually. Okay, so almost got that turret.
Almost. Maybe next time. But I believe, yeah, the Widow Mines will recharge by then anyway, so the Widow Mines are just destroying all of those Locusts before they even get anything done.
And Forrest is actually maxed, so he's just going to hang out in front of Big Kahuna's base.
133 army supply versus 57.
What would Big Kahuna need to do here, other than, like, have Forrest kill himself a bit? And then get infestors for one?
Yeah, if you could get a good,
like, the best fungals in the
on
world.
The ramp, like, if you can chain fungal the ramp as Forrest tries to make it up, maybe.
But it's a little too late for that. He's going up the ramp now. All of these swarm hosts are going to die. Those two Locusts are going to get pretty much nothing done. He's just drawing out the inevitable. Big Kahuna wondering if he won. You know what? He won our hearts with his swarm host play, and GG Forrest is going to take game one. Forrest Gump in this situation, it's a very tiny ramp for him to wall off at the front, and it's quite protected back here, and Big Kahuna won't actually have those mutas anytime soon.
That is for sure.
So the factory is put down near the front of the base.
Lining up to possibly, yeah, do the reactor switch, reactor on the barracks that just started.
So this will probably be for a bunch of Hellions that Forrest brings in with the Reaper to do some harassment, maybe kill a couple drones, hopefully get a queen. Is he going to get that drone? He's going to kill a Ling first and then target down that weakened drone.
Gets it. There we go.
So he does get a few kills here. That Reaper's really low.
And it will escape. Now, where are the queens? Are there no queens out?
No, there are. Queens out. I think they just came out.
Now we might actually see a starport. I think we will. Yeah,
so just put it down.
Banshee follow up probably.
So with this, you could do, as you said, the old switcheroo with a tech lab, get the Banshee and the cloak, and then come in through the front of the Zerg base with a couple Hellions and that Reaper.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a lot of Lings looking to do some damage to the wall. Not gonna get anything done.
Yeah, and the Hellions get out just in time to deny the wall poke. And
another quick lair for Big Kahuna.
Yep, quick lair, Roachworn, playing fairly defensive. Needs to lift up that... There we go. Lifts up the starport. Going to start the Banshee any moment now.
I think these are actually just going to be defensive roaches.
Yeah, doesn't want to deal with the potential Hellbat timing, so you get a few roaches, or at least you have the Roach Warren in case you need it.
He's starting to spy some spine crawlers as well. He knows that he needs to buy a little bit more time for the roaches to come out. The Hellions actually are... Okay. They're now going to the main, or... No, change their mind. Again? No, now they're going to the main.
Those Hellions could have roasted a few of the lanes, but they're just going to meet up with the Hellions that are currently at the third base. So they'll be able to pick off at that hatchery. Roaches are out to help deflect this, and roaches are just so good at killing Hellions.
Yeah, but they're so slow, the Hellions can just retreat back. Now the Banshee is on the way. The second one also being in production. I think it was maybe just barely missed by that Overseer. So while these Hellions and Reapers and Reaper is very distracting at the front of the base, this Banshee is going to get as much work as it possibly can get done in the natural. There are no Spore Crawlers up currently. How many drones is it going to get? Oh, gets that one trying to turn into a Spore Crawler. Banshees do two-hit drones. This Queen could possibly be taken down as well.
It looks like it will be. And I think that's a pretty great choice because the Overseer is in production. The Queen's the only thing they could really shoot up anyway, though. And there's also nothing really stopping this in the main. Overseer is now out, so this Queen will be able to... go to work, but if he just focuses down some more drones, he's going to get a lot of work done. How many kills does this get? 10 kills already. Okay. Oh, goes down.
Loses it. Well, I suppose that's okay. Since he got so much work done, one of those kills was a queen. I'm not sure where the second Banshee went.
Second Banshee. Let's see.
Maybe he canceled it. No?
No. It's.
I guess just going to meet up with the Hellions. Nidus for Big Kahuna again. Maybe feeling the pressure.
Possibly. And, yeah, I guess just... Well, with this Roach Force, you don't really want to move out on the map with it in case the Banshees do find your Roaches mid-map. You'll lose a few just trying to walk over there. So if you Nidus in, then that saves the transport time. Makes it so you don't really need Roach speed either. Has that been researched? Okay, it has been researched.
Well, there is an Overseer. I think that's an Overseer. Never mind. It died. Okay, so there's an Overlord behind the backyard expansion of Forest Gump and an Overlord near the front yard expansion as well. He could build a Nidus at either of these locations or both.
Yeah, both is a definite possibility.
And this hatchery is actually going to go down.
Yeah, I don't think he cares about it anymore, though. I think he's going all in on this Nidus pressure.
Well, I think he definitely has to forfeit that base because he doesn't have anything to take care of it right now.
Yeah. He actually morphed an Overseer next to that, even though he already had an Overseer there. There's just, like, the only issue is that there's nothing that shoots up. Like, that's the only problem there. And the Banshee will get away.
Well, that Nidus did complete, but the Roaches just ended up walking across the map anyway, so I suppose the Hydras that are going to be morphed in shortly.
But this is a really nice defensive position. Four Widow Mines, a bunch of Marauders.
Sending one Roach at a time.
Oh,
no.
God.
It's going to get some really good hits on those Roaches. That supply depot needs to be repaired.
Nothing's being
pulled.
It's
on fire.
It might fall down. It takes a while for that to burn down, but I think it's going to go. The SCV's come. Are they going to get it? They will.
Just in time. It's on fire, like your name if you're super cool and support ASL.
It turns out... before they moved over there to repair. And these lanes should probably leave.
These lanes are going to do what they want.
Yeah, okay. Okay, they'll do what they want. Start chipping away at this base. Not going to be able to kill it, that's for sure. And I'd really like to see the Nidus pop up maybe, you know, between the main and the natural.
Or there's some dead space, or where there's visionless for Forrest Gump. Ah, that Overlord catches that Banshee. Trying to sneak in.
So the defense should be ready for the Banshee. Is there going to be a response to it? I believe there are spores in the natural. Banshee is getting hit.
I don't think he ever made any Hydras.
Nope.
Okay, so this Banshee's going to die now. Actually, that's four. Hydra's finally in production.
Okay, so yeah, very big Roach Hydra mid-game. Drop loads up in the main of Forrest Gump. It's going to move across the map, try and do some damage. And Big Kahuna's chasing down that bio with his roaches.
This is only a small portion of Forrest Gump's army. Like, Big Kahuna's in some serious trouble, so it's 3-base versus 3-base. And Forrest Gump has, like, a ton more workers and mules. Like, he's just gonna max out, walk over there, and kill him. Actually, you could just do that right now.
Yeah, double the army swat. We got Swarm Host.
Okay.
And Flying Locust.
So he's maybe going to use these to fly in at the backyard expansion. I know that's popular among Hydra. Actually.
Yeah. I mean, I've seen it a few other times, but we most recently saw it from Hydra at the WCS Finals. So it could be emulating that style, but there aren't really, like, yeah, just two Swarmless. And I guess, I mean, the Locusts do a lot of DPS, but two seems like...
That's not quite enough. You need, like, four or five.
Yeah, I think the magic number is
I think it's actually five.
Yeah, five to snipe a Town Hall in one volley. And if it takes you more than one volley, well, one, the Terran can repair it, and two, that's, like, they're a minute apart.
Yeah, that's true. It does take an awfully long time with that change because of fire cake. Anyway, it looks like Forrest is getting ready to go and kill Big Kahuna. Oh, that one of mine does get sniped. All these roaches. Some get caught behind the Hydras, but there are definitely not enough roaches here to buffer for the Hydras. Even though the Hydras do, they do a ton of DPS, but there's so much bio here. Big Kahuna in a big heap of trouble. He's getting dumped on by Forrest Gump and the Dump Truck Green. Burrow is not going to be enough in this case. That 100 is a little suicidal. So are these three. Oh my god. Those Hydras. Oh,
The Locusts try and get something done. Yeah, shot down by Widowmines.
Okay, that's the wrong direction.
Okay. That's fine. That's fine.
Well, it did kill one thing.
Yeah.
But this third is going to go down. Forrest Gump is going to be on four bases soon.
I'm not sure
it's
if
not
you
gonna matter.
That you don't have to burrow the Swarm Host anymore.
Yeah,
they
you
just
need,
do their own thing.
You can just, like, trigger them. So now Big Kahuna stuck in his main. These Locusts are gonna try and get something done, but there's so many medevacs with this bio, and this is really it. I mean, Big Kahuna was in a heap of trouble earlier, but now he's really gonna feel the pressure.
I think
this bio is kind of like blocking itself, actually. Okay, so almost got that turret.
Almost. Maybe next time. But I believe... Yeah, the Widowmines will recharge by then anyway, so... the Widowmines are just destroying all of those locusts before they even get anything done.
And Forest is actually maxed, so he's just going to hang out in front of Big Kuna's base.
133 army supply versus 57.
What would Big Kuna need to do here, other than, like, have Forrest kill himself a bit? And then get infestors, for one?
Yeah, if you could get a good
like the best fungals in the world
on the ramp. Like, if you can chain fungal the ramp as Forrest tries to make it up, maybe.
But it's a little too late for that. He's going up the ramp now. All of these swarm hosts are going to die. Those two locusts are going to get pretty much nothing done. He's just drawing out the inevitable. Big Kuna wondering if he won. You know what? He won our hearts with his swarm host play. And GG for us is going to take game one. In the honeycomb yellow, it's Big Kuna. And in the bottom right, in the recycling truck green, it's Forrest Gump.
Honeycomb big? What? Is there a joke I don't get?
We probably don't get the same commercials.
Yeah. Okay, Saber's saying it's a commercial, but we have not seen it. So joke is just like way over the head. Too sophisticated for us.
Yeah, I guess. So, is SCV gonna take a look around? Oh, it's getting drowned. Oh my god, it's
on attack move. When do you attack move your scout? Okay.
God damn it! It's not a proxy hatch drone!
He's gonna be a pool first as well. So we might see another one base play. I mean, he could have seen how effective that actually was. Gas is going up as well.
There's another scouting drone! Come on, proxy hatch, it can still happen. It can still happen. Come on!
Now, in this situation, I don't think it's okay. It's okay. Next time
it's
there
still
might be
there.
A proxy hatch. But in this situation, I think that the 14-14 isn't going to be quite as effective because of the spawns in the last map. Forrest Gump was forced to make the reactor as part of the wall, and it's a very exposed and weak part of it. But on this map, he'll be able to make the reactor behind the barracks. If he was in the top position, it could be an issue again. But since he's in the bottom, this will no longer be a situation.
My god, that overlord. Oh my god, that overlord. What? Okay.
It should get away.
I was, like, way stressed out because there was no proxy hatch. Even though it's, like, one of the least common things you see. Aside from, like, I don't know, carrier rush.
Six pool.
Yeah, you're right. I've only seen a few six pools in the GSL. And definitely more than a few proxy hatches. Okay, fine, whatever. But I don't like six pool as much as proxy hatch, so. I don't care what six pool. Plus, that's just kind of bad. Anyway, Forrest, I'm taking that quick command center. He's going to be pretty safe behind this wall, and he does have a bunker ready for when his units start coming out. He does not opt for the Reaper this time, though.
No, he doesn't. And actually, big drone Maynard. So that's actually something that you don't see too often anymore because it actually doesn't make very much difference. The you know, back in Brood War, it would have been very effective to move eight of your drones over because you'd be getting more optimal saturation, but in this version, you actually lose out because you're losing that mining time. And as long as you have less than 16 on your main, then you will be good.
Yeah, it's actually better to rally your drones from your main to your natural until you have full optimal saturation.
Yes. The only real benefit is that in this situation, the main will mine out slower. So if you get into a situation where you haven't taken your fourth or your fifth as quick as you would like to, you'll have a bit more of a buffer time while your main is still mining.
Because you didn't mine more to begin with, and then maybe when you be in that situation, but that's a whole other story. So we're going to see the old switcheroo with the starport, and probably for a cloak banshee again.
Very fast spire, too.
Yeah, so we're going to have two base muta, and this has actually been pretty popular among quite a few players. I'm thinking of course, the GSL. That's like one of my favorite things to watch.
Yeah, I mean, two-base mute has been a pretty popular build among players across the spectrum. We've even seen it a lot in lower-level tournaments like this ASL. We've been seeing it in the WCS qualifiers, the GSL. It's just a pretty solid build right now, and it gives you some map presence going into the mid-game.
I think we saw quite a bit actually in Southeast Asia.
Yes, we did.
Okay, so Big Kahuna, 4 evolution chamber wall.
for
these Hellions, because he does not have enough army to take this out, and I totally respect this move.
And those Hellions are not getting in anymore, and if he wants, now he can get quadruple upgrades.
Yeah, because there are 4 different types of upgrades. Actually, they're in a 5th evolution chamber,
okay.
Too.
Yeah, 5 upgrades. Why not?
Okay, so these spines. About halfway down, the queen can just pick at the Hellions, but they're not getting anything done. No way.
Well, I mean, they can just look at that wall and be like, okay, so we did enough damage already by existing.
Yeah, I suppose so.
I mean, they essentially killed 3 drones there because you're only going to want the 2 Evos, as well as 75 minerals each. You know, that was a pretty big investment to get this wall up. Double spine, that's 2 more drones and an extra chunk of money. I mean, this is...
Plus all the mining time you could have had with those drones.
Exactly. Like, this is just so much non-direct damage done by the presence of these Hellions.
And he does put 3 spores up. This Banshee is going to get quite a bit of work done before they're done. And I don't think there's an Overseer in production quite yet. This queen's going to just kind of dance around the buildings. Oh, the spore does finish in time. The banshee's
got
to be careful. It's going to go down without even taking that queen out.
So a bit of indecision there. It was targeting on the queen, then it went back to drones, back to the queen. But the mutas are in the main, and they're doing some damage. Getting some workers down. And Forrest Gump is pretty low on workers already, and no real response.
He should take down that worker that's building the engineering bay.
Yes, so that there can't be any turrets.
Yeah.
Bit too late for that, but he's going to get these Hellions for free, too. Got to pull back with those Mutas, though. Don't want to lose them to those Marines.
Oh, man, that's really bad. Like, Mutas, they're really gas-heavy. Okay, so one will survive here. But that was definitely not worth it for Big Kahuna.
And he can swing a few Mutas back to deal with that Banshee.
Oh my god. That spore's gonna get up!
Oh, the spore
oh my
does
god.
Get up, and the Banshee will go down without killing either the queen or the spore. Again, like, I mean, that was just an issue where the AI of the Banshee took over and
did something stupid.
Yes.
Or less optimal.
Less optimal. But with some good micro, then that's a situation that could have been avoided. If we look at the worker supply, Forrest Gump is down 7.
Oh, the Widow Mine hit took out at least 1 Mutalisk. Actually, no, it just took out 1. So Mutalisk can now pick at this wall when Marine's going to do, like, nothing.
Yeah, actually would do nothing. I mean, one Mutalisk can take a Marine head-on, and if you include the fact that there are 8 Mutas here, then that Marine has 0 chances.
Okay, so Forrest needs to get a ton more Marines out to deal with these mutilists. Does he have stim complete? I totally missed that. No, he doesn't have stim.
Not even in production.
So he's going to have a really difficult time dealing with these mutilists.
Yeah, you just can't really chase them down without stim. And even with it, you know, you're kind of reliant on the long range but clunky Thor to help zone them out when they're in your base.
Yeah, clunky is a really good term for that because, like, they are incredibly slow. The mutilists can just dance around them. Or magic box, the Thor, which is when they come in from, like, multiple directions and then they're not clumped up anymore. And they take the Thor out with relative ease, depending on your number of mutilists. But it looks like Forrest Gump is going to just rely on Viking and some good Widowmine hits.
I mean, the Widowmine placement is really nice, but he doesn't have any of those, you know, really nice situations where there are a bunch of Widowmines clumped up to maybe get a lucky hit. It's just they're here to zone out the mutas, not necessarily kill them. Because with the way they are right now, the mutas have to realize that if they want to go in the base, they're going to lose at least one muta every time. So you have to commit hard enough that you're going to recover, like, you know, that 100 minerals, 100 gas.
But only from that direction. Like, over here, like, that's actually really sneaky with my placement. They're almost covered by the refinery.
Mm-hmm.
But, Forrest is going to need a little bit more than that. Combat shield on the way.
Well, he kills one of his Evos, so now he can get out of there.
Well, he had to.
Yeah, well, actually,
I thought he could have Nidus out.
Yeah, I thought he was going to Nidus out. But, no, taking down one of those Evo chambers, deciding he's only going to get 4 upgrades at a time.
I just heard Banelian's morphing in. Okay, there are 10 Banelian's morphing in.
But that is a lot of Widowmines, and a good Widowmine hit can annihilate this army.
They're exposed right now. Okay, mutas, do not go after them. Widowmines coming. Oh my god, these Banelians are going to get destroyed.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, you know, watch out with those mutilists, though. That is
it. Okay, so he's baiting. But there's still 4 that are active.
That was a nice bit of splash damage on those Marines, though. You know, they were being killed exclusively by the glaive damage in that situation.
Okay, now that they're...
Oh, God, the mutas.
So close. This is, like, super playing with fire. Super playing with fire. This is like you're sticking your hand in a 1500-degree furnace.
Yes. Now, Baneling speed has never been started. You really need the Baneling speed.
Well, okay, this is a lot of turrets, and still only one Viking. I believe the Widowmine was focused down by the Mutalisk, but the Mutalisks are actually getting quite low. They need to back off.
Yep. And still Baneling speed not started.
Stim's, like, finally been started.
I can't tell what is a more crucial upgrade in this situation, Stim or Baneling speed.
I don't know, but both of these players need to have been taking, like, a 4th, almost. Well, especially Big Kahuna.
Yeah.
And there's actually no reason for Big Kahuna to be on 2 bases still.
No, because he has map presence with the Mutalisk. He totally could have taken that 3rd.
Like, ages ago. He's got a ton of minerals. He's going to need more gas if he wants to keep building Mutalisk. And he's just keeping Forrest running around his base.
Mm-hmm. He might be having difficulties with the multitasking. That's what I'm maybe seeing in this situation. And there's so many Banelings, but there is no Baneling speed. They try to go up this ramp, they're going to get killed by all of those Widowmines. Like, they'll probably take out a bunker, and that's pretty much it.
So this drop is Forrest's attempt to pull the mutas back, and it's actually going to work quite nicely. All of the mutalists come back, and they're getting quite a few drone kills, as well as a queen that medevac is actually going to go down to the spore. And Forrest's actually very worried about the 3rd and 4th to scan the top bases, thinking, you know, he's got to have a ton of bases now, right? But he actually doesn't, and a huge lane flood coming in. Oh my god, the Banelings are going to Oh my god, oh, don't put on my head.
But if you still connect, no, you're not going to connect with the bot. Oh, maybe it will.
Oh,
there's not
god.
Really that much splitting going on. Okay.
So, the buyer retreats up the ramp. Mutas are coming in now. All the Widow Mines did get their shots off already, but there's a lot of bio left over, and, you know, Stim Marines are pretty darn good at killing Mutalisk.
There's also, those Widow Mines are going to reset soon, but that was such a colossal waste of Banelings.
Yeah, he needed to, like, throw up a few smaller clumps of Banelings first instead of just running everything up the ramp, or the other option is having Baneling speed.
Yes, Baneling speed, or if you put in, if you have them come in like one by one,
mm-hmm.
so they're in a like a line instead of clumped,
yep.
then that one Widow Mine shot would not have killed like 10 of them.
Yeah, only like 4.
Yeah, exactly. That would have been a lot better. But Big Kahuna is still keeping 4S in his base. Big Sim forward.
Yes, will get doesn't away. Get any of the mutas. Yeah.
Finally a third on the way for Big Kahuna. He should probably just take a fourth and fifth at the same time.
Yeah, he has the map presence to do it, but like the worker counts on both sides are quite low. They haven't really been hitting their macro cycles. 36 workers for Forrest Gump versus 41 for Big Kahuna. You know, they don't have that constant worker production. And, I mean, part of the problem for Forrest Gump is that they've been so all-in on this two-base muta situation.
One marine. That one marine. Oh, man. Yeah, so, infestation pit coming down at the 22-minute mark.
As well as burrow.
This could be for Baneling Mines.
Could be for Baneling Mines. It could also be Swarm Host again. I mean, he did go Swarm Host in Game 1. Wasn't the most effective thing in the world, but you could argue that he was already dead by that point anyway.
Yeah.
Oh
my
those
god,
these are on
move command. Now all these Mutalisks are just going to kill all this bio for pretty much free. Except that one Marine that's running away frantically. These Banelings have no idea what they're doing.
Baneling speed still not started.
Well, you know, sometimes you just don't want to spend the money on Baneling speed.
I guess not. Now, he's going to have to get that fourth going soon because the main is already mined out. So he's just going from
two base. Now, Forrest is he's doing a good job at trying to get some harassment done, but the Mutas just keep shutting it down. Okay, more Banelings. Very slowly walking up towards the third and the natural of Forrest Gump. Forrest does scan the third. Oh my god, these Banelings are clumped again. Oh my god, the Widow Mine didn't go off!
They connect with the bio.
And then the Widow Mine friendly fires those Marines to death.
And those go taking down the rocks, okay.
I think that's actually debris again, because it used to be a cooling tower. But
okay, yeah, taking down the debris. Those Medivacs were a little exposed, but they boost out of there just in time. The Widow Mines?
Okay, so the Overseer is going to sacrifice itself. But
nice move, too, because it splashes on top of the bio.
Sending in a few Mutalisk and one more Overseer to bait the trigger of those Widow Mines. Again, that's a lot of Widow Mines. Like, that's a lot of Widow Mines.
There are more Widow Mines than Marines. 22 Widow Mines, 15 Marines.
That is so many Widow Mines. Okay, so, really, where are the 4th, 5th, and potentially 6th bases? Tunneling Claws would be pretty helpful in this situation.
Yes, it would be, since there are so many Widow Mines, and it could also potentially catch Big Kahuna off guard.
Sacrificing a couple of those Mutalisks to bait the fire of the Widow Mines. Every time these Widow Mines unburrow, the Mutalisks are coming in to pick a few of them off, sacrificing one more. There's no more Overseer with this army. Where is the Overseer?
I don't think he realizes that Widow Mines don't splash on each other.
I don't think so either.
Oh, but a lot of them go down there, between the glaive and the fact that a lot of them were already weakened. And, okay, Ultralis Cavern is completed. So if Big Kahuna can maybe buy a bit more time, you know, Widow Mines aren't that great against Ultralisk.
Oh my god, this is...
But there aren't any in production. He's got the money, he's got the gas, he can make a few Ultralisk, but... None are being made. Oh my god, those meters are so low!
That's three Widow Mine hits right there.
They could be tickled to death.
So this base is more than likely going to be forfeit.
Yeah, you can't engage with the mutas anymore. You have to hold them back. And without a third base, then this is pretty much...
This is looking more and more like Forrest Gump is going to take this with the lack of fourth, fifth, and actually I'd even say sixth at the 28-minute mark.
Okay, so how do you engage this as Big Kahuna? He's got a few more Overseers, so he'll be able to detect the Widow Mines.
Well...
Stormer Ultra's in production.
Gotta be very, very careful. It might be better for Big Kahuna just not to engage these Widow Mines like this. If you take some of the Mutalisk and harass with them. Or coming from this angle is also okay. But there's still the problem, like, you may accidentally get all of your Mutalisk hit by four Widow Mine shots. But most of these aren't even full health, so it could just take three.
Yeah, three would do it. Three would certainly do it on these. Okay, Overlord's coming through to tank the hits.
Okay.
It'll get on top of the bio? No, not quite.
Okay, so this is when the Mutalisk are going to try and clean up all the Widow Mines, but there's too much bio here. And he's going to lose all of his Mutalisk if he's not careful, but I don't think it matters.
Yeah, at this point, I think there's enough bio to support these. I mean,
yeah,
Big Kahuna has been fighting with pure...
It doesn't matter. Is this either base trade or...
Thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe to support the ASL by hitting the button now.